Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel, friends. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel yet, do subscribe it today and press the bell icon to receive notification about my new videos. In this video, we will see how to fix if you have lost administrative rights on your Windows 11 operating system. So let's get started. First of all, we will see what are the symptoms when you lost administrative rights in Windows 11. So whenever you do something that involves administrative privileges, you will see something like this. In this case, I have tried to open Windows PowerShell, and you can see that here the user account control confirmation prompt has been appeared, which usually have yes and no button. If you click yes, the operation will be continued, and if you click no, operation will be terminated. But in this case where you have lost administrative rights, you can see here no button only, there is no yes button there. This confirms that we have lost administrative rights on this system. While if we try to open task manager and try to create new task, you can see that here I have tried to open NetFilWiz, and here again I got the same result, and that is user account control confirmation prompt with no button. There is no yes button. And the problem of losing administrative rights becomes worse when you have the single account on your system, and that is the only account which is now user level or standard account. And this is why we are facing this problem. And fixing this is not easy task, because if you go to local users and groups snap-in and locate your one and only user account, which is user account, not an administrator account, and if you try to add it to administrator's group by assigning some permissions, but you can see here that error has occurred, and the next error is access is denied, and this is pretty obvious because we do not have administrative rights on this system. So how to resolve this problem? Now let us see our first solution, which is an easier method, and in this case we will be using settings app and do a system restore using advanced recovery option. Kindly note that if you perform system restore using the old system restore dialog present in the control panel, you won't be able to do that because of losing administrative rights. So you have to go to settings app, then system, then recovery, and under recovery options you will find advanced startup. Click on the restart now button next to it. In the pop-up window, click on restart now, and your system will be now restarted, and under choose an option, click troubleshoot, advanced options, and under advanced options, click on system restore. Kindly note that this method will only work if you have system restore points created before losing administrative rights. If you do not have a system restore point created in advance, then you can refer second method, which I will be sharing in this video next. Now back to system restore wizard, click on the next button, select the system restore point created earlier and click next, and then click on finish button. Click yes in the confirmation prompt and let the system restore be working in the background. This will take a while depending upon your data on the system. And once this system restore has been completed, you will find that your lost administrative rights are now back. So here in this case, system restore has completed successfully. We will now need to restart the system. So after restart, we will try to login back to our account, which is the one and only account on this system. And we will check if the administrative rights are now back. So here you can see that again we have a message, system restore completed successfully. This is usual message after login and when you perform system restore. Simply click on the close button here. Now we will again try to open Windows PowerShell and see if we can now open it and bypass the user account control confirmation prompt. So here you can see that yes button is now back, and we can easily click on it to proceed further. Next, we can see here that administrative Windows PowerShell is here. That means we have gained our lost administrative rights. If we try to open NetFilWiz, you can see that under user accounts applet, the group membership of the one and only account has been changed to administrators. That means the problem is 100% fixed here. Now, in case if this method doesn't work for you because of no system restore points created in advanced, we have got the second method, which is using registry, and in this case we will edit registry in the Windows recovery environment. So we will right click on the start button again and go to settings, app, and then system, and then under recovery options click restart now next to advanced startup, and then again click on restart now in the pop-up window. Once your system is now restarted, it will again go back to the choose an option screen. Click on troubleshoot here, then select advanced options, then under advanced options select command prompt this time. When the command prompt opens, type regedit and press enter key to open registry editor. In the registry editor window, highlight H key local machine, then click file and then load hive. When load hive pop-up appears, select your system root drive where Windows is installed. In this case, it is C drive. Then go to Windows folder. Under Windows, locate system32 folder and go inside it. Under system32 folder, you have to locate config folder and open it. Inside config folder, you will find a file named SAM. Select it and then click open. In the load hive key name, type REM_SAM and click OK. Now expand hkey local machine registry key, then go to REM_SAM, then SAM, then domains, then expand account, then go to users, then expand it and locate the first registry subkey here. That is 00001F4. In the right pane of this registry subkey, you will find F named registry binary D word. Double click on it, go to line number 38, place the cursor in the right side of 11 and press delete key, and then type 10, that is 10, and finally click on the OK button here. Close the registry editor and also command prompt, and from here you can continue, or better if you select turn off your PC option and restart your system. When you restart your system, you will be able to log into built-in administrator account, which is now enabled, and using that built-in administrator account you can create another administrative accounts on the system, or you can also modify existing standard level user account on the system and make them administrator, and this will help you to gain the administrative rights back on your Windows 11 operating system. If you have any question about these methods, do let me know via your comments. I'll be happy to help you, and that's it for now in this video. Thanks for watching it. If you found it helpful, do like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos.